Could everyone please stand and join me in saying the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Good morning and welcome, teachers, faculty, family, friends, and of course, 2015 graduates of Hamilton High School.
Please be seated, Alex. Please.
Can everyone please be seated? Thank you. Before I begin, I'd like to give a little disclaimer. I hope all of you weren't expecting much out of this speech, because like every other paper I've completed these last 4 years, this was written the night before. So here goes nothing. Now I know that for many of you, this is the first time that you've gotten out of bed before 11 since school let out last Friday. But waking up early doesn't seem so bad when you know that today is going to be special. We're gathered here to celebrate a terrific achievement. 12 years of hard work culminates today, the day that we will finally be able to call ourselves graduates of Hamilton High School. Today not only marks the end of an era, but it is also the beginning of a new chapter of our lives. Some of my fondest childhood memories are going to almost every Hamilton basketball and football game since I was a baby. When I was younger, I used to dream about playing basketball and baseball for the Big Blue. But around my sophomore year, I realized that being 5'6" and 130 pounds with not a whole lot of athletic ability wasn't going to cut it at the varsity level. So, although my dreams of being a two-sport athlete didn't exactly come true, I still enjoyed every second that I spent here at Hamilton High School, and it's really hard to believe that it's over. You know, high school really is a roller coaster ride full of ups and downs. For example, I'm proud to say that I finished with a 5.06 GPA. But on the downside, I also finished with 0.00 girls. My point is, high school wasn't always easy, but life after high school isn't going to be easy either. These past 12 years, we've all been traveling down the same path together, but once we receive our diplomas a short time from now, our paths begin to split. Some of you will be heading off to college in August. Some of you are enlisting in the armed forces. Some of you are jumping right into a career. And some of you don't know what you're doing yet, and that's okay. No matter what path you choose to take, each road you travel on will have its own unique sets of challenges. And the only way to overcome those challenges is by taking chances. The great one, Wayne Gretzky, once said, "You miss 100% of the shots you don't take." In the end, we only regret the chances that we didn't take, so don't let fear hold you back. So now, as we walk across the stage to receive our diplomas, our lives will become drastically different. Whatever path you choose to follow from here on out is going to cause us all to slowly drift away from each other. But at the end of the day, we are all held together by a special bond. We're all a part of Hamilton High School's class of 2015. So that concludes my welcome speech. Unfortunately for all of you, you're not done listening to me talk yet, because I'll be back up here at the end of the program to give closing remarks. But for now, I'm going to turn over the podium to a very special person. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce to you the man, the myth, the legend, Hamilton High's very own, Mr. John Wilhelm.
Wow. Thank you, Alex, for that introduction. There are a few things that are legendary, and I think you're going to be speaking about them 20 years from now, about your senior year in high school, that's for sure. As principal of Hamilton High School, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our administrative staff and distinguished guests. Please hold your applause until all are introduced. In the first row, seated from left to right, Mr. Gene Hutzelman, assistant principal, Mrs. Patty Gibbons, assistant principal, Mrs. Jana Lewis, assistant principal, Alex Shooter, senior class president, Mrs. Janet Baker, superintendent of schools, Roberto Castillo Gould, valedictorian, Cassidy Hicks, salutatorian, Mr. Matt Shermer, assistant principal, and Ms. Jessie Weisbrod, assistant principal. In the second row, from left to right, Mr. Todd Grimm, athletic director, Mr. Tyler Ballou, assistant athletic director, Mr. Brandon Stanfield, principal, Garfield Middle School, Mr. Jeff Miller, principal, Hamilton Freshman School, Mrs. Cheryl Burke, principal, Wilson Middle School. In our Board of Education, Mr. Larry Bowling, board member, Mr. Steve Isgro, board member, Mr. Scott Kruger, president, Hamilton Board of Education, Dr. Glenn Stitzinger, board member, and Mr. Rob Weigel, board member. Seated behind our graduates are part of the faculty and staff of Hamilton High School in the Hamilton Freshman Building. At this time, I do want to acknowledge all of the staff in the Hamilton City School District. So if we could have all the staff please stand to be recognized. Thank you for everything that you do for our students. I'd like to draw your attention to our piano to my right. On the piano are white roses. These roses are symbolic for all of those who are not able to be in attendance with us this morning. Students, faculty, staff, distinguished guests, parents, grandparents, friends and relatives of the graduates. Today we are here to honor the graduates of Hamilton High School. Today, we celebrate the culmination of their educational careers within the Hamilton City School District. Parents, I want to personally thank you for all that you have done to support the education of your child. Your guidance is imperative to the student success, and the staff at Hamilton High School certainly appreciates it. To the Hamilton High School class of 2015, congratulations. Today, your hard work has paid off. As I look over the floor of Millett Hall, I find myself awestruck by the tremendous talents of this group of seniors. I see scholars, I see apprentices, I see volunteers, community activists, leaders, interns, artists, musicians, performers, athletes. I see students who already impact our world and will continue to do so in the future. I saw this every day at Hamilton High School. And while I will not see this group as a whole in our hallways again, I know that you will take what you have learned at Hamilton High School and create new successes and new triumphs. This year has been full of accomplishments from our seniors in the classroom, in the community, on the stage, on the job, on the field of play. It has been a great year at Big Blue. For many reasons, seniors, this graduating class will always be special to me. It is the first senior class that I had the pleasure to graduate as principal of Hamilton High School. When we met in August, it was my goal to make this year a rewarding and positive experience for each one of you. I hope now, on the precipice of a very important moment in your life, that you feel the same. Students, I am truly honored to be your principal. Today I stand before you with the deepest gratitude, not only for the many wonderful achievements and accomplishments, but how you represent our city and how you represent our building. I will always remember this group fondly. And I hope that you have the same fondness for Hamilton High School. Hamilton High School is a special place. There is not another high school like it. You should be proud not only of your accomplishments, but also the support and opportunities you were afforded in your time at Big Blue. In August, teachers and administrators excitedly welcomed you to your senior year. Today, with that same vigor, we welcome you to your future. Author David Brooks wrote, "Almost every successful person begins with two beliefs. The future can be better than the present, and I have the power to make it so." Right now, the present is pretty good. Today we celebrate you. I'm sure there will be parties and family gatherings throughout the weekends, as well there should be. Celebrate your accomplishments and honor those who helped you along the way. It's okay to revel in your success. But soon the celebrations will end and the real work will begin. I feel confident that you have the tools to be successful, that you are prepared for college, career, and life. Now you will decide the future. You do have the power to make it so. And so allow me to challenge you to continue to press on, to strive toward your ever-changing future. I challenge you to continue to represent yourself with character and continue to make us all Hamilton proud. Thank you for all that you do for our building, our district, and our community. Good luck in your future endeavors. I have no doubt that there will be great things in store for each one of you. Congratulations and thank you. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the superintendent of the Hamilton City School District, Mrs. Janet Baker.
Good morning. What a pleasure and a privilege it is to be here on this beautiful Memorial Day weekend. I'm going to start my comments this morning with a little bit of a confession. A few weeks ago, I realized, you know, I'd been putting off getting on paper what I wanted to say today. And the reason was is because it's the last of 23 graduation speeches I've had the privilege of making during my tenure as superintendent. As many of you may know, I'm retiring this summer with 44 years in education, with 23 of those in the superintendency. I suppose I procrastinated a little bit because I felt this need to make this my best speech ever. And that was going to be difficult because I find the decision bittersweet. I've truly loved my career and the staff and colleagues who have made it so special. Like me, our seniors have made good friends and have been motivated and inspired by truly exceptional teachers. So it's difficult for both of us to say goodbye. On the other hand, moving on is the natural progression of life, and we must both continue to move forward in each new season, and that can be exciting and rewarding. So a few days ago, I decided to stop worrying about finding some creative approach and simply capture five ideas, five pieces of advice that will help you and me. Number one, the future is and always will be unknown. And that truth in and of itself makes us just a little bit nervous because we don't know what lies ahead. But we do know the possibilities are endless and they're exciting. Embrace that uncertainty, knowing that, as your principal said, you're well prepared for whatever comes your way. Number two, the future is full of very important life choices. For you, will you go into the workforce or further your education? Will you continue to live in our community or will you relocate? Will you marry one of your classmates or someone that maybe you haven't even met yet? Embrace life's important choices but be careful to choose wisely. Number three, the future is really all about setting your sights high and dreaming big, daring dreams. There's nothing that you can't achieve if you believe in yourself and are willing to work to set and achieve your goals. So embrace the challenge of high expectations and surpass whatever you believe is even possible. Number four, the future unfolds as you reflect and build on past successes. So as you think about your years here at Big Blue and the successful ones, you will gain or restore the confidence that you need to take the next step. Success is truly achieved one small step at a time. Embrace your past successes and use that momentum to help you achieve even bigger successes into your future. And finally, number five, the future is the life you will live on a daily basis, and it will become your life legacy. Will you choose to have strong character, show respect for yourself and others, be responsible, and invest in others? You, the class of 2015, are role models, and you will leave a school legacy for all of the students who will follow you. Embrace your personal legacy by living your best life every single day, starting today. So today, we're here to celebrate you, to close the doors on high school in order to open the doors to an even brighter future. Savor this moment and move forward with the joy and pride that comes from being an amazing Hamilton High grad. My strong belief is that we have all been blessed with unique gifts and talents, and that there's a perfect plan for each of our lives. My wish for you, and also for my next chapter in life, is good health, happiness, and that we all live in a way that leaves behind a truly rich and lasting legacy. Thank you. And now the fun part. We get to celebrate our valedictorian and salutatorian. The valedictorian is Roberto Alexander Castillo Gell, the son of Roberto Castilla and Miriam Gell. Roberto has earned a weighted GPA of 5.25. He has earned gold honor roll status and received an advanced placement scholar award. Roberto has been a member of the National Honor Society, the Astra Service Club, Miss Jewett's Do It Club, and the Bible Club for 2 years. He's been a participant in the Volunteer Club for 1 year, doing all of that while he maintained a full-time job. He also volunteers at St. Julie Billiard and tutors in Spanish and Algebra 2. Roberto plans to attend Wright State University in Dayton, Ohio, and his goal is to focus on a double major in chemistry and Spanish with either a pre-med or pre-dentistry track. Please help me thank and acknowledge Roberto Alexander Castillo Gell.
Good morning. First off, I would like to thank God, all of my mentors and friends that I have had throughout my education. At first, I wanted to give the most inspirational speech that Hamilton has heard, but eventually I decided to write one that is dear to me and represented my journey through school. It's finally here after many years of classes, although the years were arduous and also full of excitement. We learned our passions and began to think of our future professions. As these school years progressed, we enjoyed our time Snapchatting, tweeting, and Instagramming our every moments, rather than planning ahead to accomplish our objectives. Collectively, we have believed we are perfect in every aspect. Our peers elevated our confidence, so we thought we were deserving of everything. Although, life was not always so simple for me. My parents have done so much for me that I will always thank them for. They have wanted to protect me from life in the United States, but no matter how hard they tried, I could not hide my nationality. I felt that I could not escape the stereotype of the hardworking Mexican that is unable to speak English. As a child, I did not view college as an option for my life. However, my parents told me, as long as I tried as much as I could, they would ensure that I attend a university. There were days when I no longer wanted to participate in rigorous courses, which is why I did not fully focus on making my dream a reality. Prestige was what went through my mind when applying to universities. Yale was my dream school, but like dreams, I did not put effort into my application. Rather, I just believed I would be bestowed an admissions letter. I felt as if my world was over when I was not accepted. The days preceding the rejection were the worst. I did not want to be seen because I felt like a failure. Luckily, I had friends that helped me progress from my downfall. I realized that all is for the best. We cannot cling to our failures, but rather look to future success through hard work and dedication. A better opportunity to succeed and accomplish one's dreams will be available. Search for it. It is out there. There are many that view Hamilton in such a negative manner. However, I do not see how that is possible. I am glad to have attended Hamilton High School. It was not the technology or the subjects that had such an impact, but rather the rich diversity of people. My classmates are optimists, even in the face of adversity. Their optimism began to grow on me, and ever since then, I am happier and feel as I am more prepared for the world, and I am more accepted by my peers. It is a school that has helped me form great friendships, friendships that will last for many years to come. With the help of my friends, I have explored and learned what truly interests me. And as many know, I smile a lot, and there is a reason for that. Life. Life is truly a gift bestowed upon us. We should make the most of it. Mother Teresa has once said, "We shall never know all the good that a simple smile can do." A smile is the most magnificent attribute a human has, and everyone has a beautiful one, so there is no reason not to. Just be happy and smile in the face of adversity. Struggle and disappointment allow for us to attain our hopes and objectives later in our journey. Our personal backgrounds, successes, and failures will not define our future, rather the positivity that we put back into the world. We should persevere to give back to the place that unites us all. Anything is possible through God and optimism. Thank you all. Congratulations y felicitaciones, class of 2015.
Great job, Roberto. And now it's my pleasure to introduce the 2015 salutatorian, Cassidy Marie Hicks. Cassidy is the daughter of Carrie and Melissa Hicks. She has earned a weighted GPA of 5.19 and earned either silver or gold honor roll every quarter in high school while taking various advanced placement and honors classes. Cassidy was one of only six sophomores chosen to attain the J.K. Kyle Braid Leadership Foundation Ranch in Colorado during the summer of 2013. She has been a member of the varsity tennis team for 4 years. She won the GMC tournament 3 times, earned the GMC Player of the Year 2 times, and was the Division I tennis state champion this school year. Pretty impressive. Cassidy plans to attend Wofford College in Spartanburg, South Carolina, and play on the Division I tennis team while exploring her options for a major. Please join me in welcoming your salutatorian, Cassidy Marie Hicks.
You guys, it's over. No more waking up at 6 a.m, 5 days a week to spend 7 straight hours in the same building. No more eating lunch with 500 other people. No more staying up till 1 a.m. doing homework. No more having to ask to go to the bathroom and having to carry a planner with you. No more putting everything you own into a locker that you forgot the combination to after Christmas break. No more fingertip length shorts and forced shoulder coverage. No more Tuesday schools for using headphones in the hallways. But also, no more homecoming parades and dances. No more Friday night lights. No more teachers who actually care about you. No more inside jokes that every Hamilton kid understands. No more laughing with the same people you've had classes with since middle school. No more high school sports. No more of this community. It's over, and this is it. We've gone through this together, the good times, the bad times, the struggles, the victories. We've been there for each other through it all, and today it's ending. Today we're going to throw our caps into the air and rejoice, and we will hug and cry and take pictures and go to each other's graduation parties and bring up all of the experiences we have shared, and then it'll be over. We will walk away from each other and we will start something new. A whole new world, a whole new community, maybe a whole new city, new people, new favorite restaurants, new events, new things to look forward to. And I can't help but wonder, what are you hoping to get out of that? Are you hoping it comes with new purpose, fulfillment, and joy? Are you hoping that you will finally feel a sense of real and secure and unshakable satisfaction? But weren't you hoping to get these things out of high school? Let's think about that for a second. Remember when you were a freshman and you were so eager to get into the freshman building, even if you were a little scared? You were looking for new friendships and a great academic career in the time of your life, because that's what high school is, right? Every adult will tell you that high school is the best 4 years of your life. It's so exciting and new. You go into it expecting an experience just like the movies, dances and football games and parties. And along with that, you expect joy and fulfillment, purpose and satisfaction. But somehow, these 4 years end up being filled with heartbreaks and sleepless nights and mental breakdowns and unbearable stress and feelings of failure and lost friends and finding more brokenness within your soul than you ever thought possible. You feel alone, like no one loves you, like you're replaceable, like you'll never be enough. What happened? Wasn't high school supposed to leave you feeling full of life? You guys, that was me too. I went into freshman year focused on three things: grades, tennis, and friends. I knew these were the keys to success. These were the things that would bring me a great life. So I set my heart on these things, and I put my all into these things. Freshman year, I got straight A's in all honors classes, and I got second in the GMC, being one round away from state. I became friends with those popular people that I dreamed about being friends with. Sophomore year, my perfect academic career continued, defining me as the valedictorian, and my tennis career began to soar, being ranked in the top 100 in the nation. And I had those friends that I wanted, and everything was on track for perfection. I had it all. I succeeded. I did it, and I was so proud of myself. And I was sure that now I could feel all the things I'd always desired to feel, and everyone would love me, and I would feel satisfied. But for some reason, the things that I wanted to feel weren't there. My dreams were coming true, but my heart felt like it wanted more. What more could there be? I had it all. Why wasn't it working? Did I do all of that work just to get here, just to feel empty inside? I felt so confused and alone and defeated. Do you guys know the feeling that I'm talking about? When it's 11:30 at night and the sad tweets start coming out. You know those tweets. Your parents are disappointed in you, or you're in a fight with your boyfriend or girlfriend, or you didn't get the grades you thought you needed, or you feel like the unimportant friend, or you feel like you're simply not good enough. You begin to question everything. What's my purpose? What's the point of doing all these things I do just to be left feeling like this? Does anyone really love me? Why can't I have all the things my heart so desperately desires? Or maybe you feel this not when something bad is happening, but after something absolutely great happens. You feel like you've gotten what you wanted, and you lay in bed to go to sleep, and you can't help but search the depths of your soul, and that fulfillment that you thought you were finally going to get has left you emptier than ever before. A man named Rabbi Zacharias once said, "The loneliest moment in life is when you have just experienced that which you thought would deliver the ultimate, and it has just let you down." I felt this over and over again. Do you know what I'm talking about? Loneliness, brokenness, and emptiness. I'm sure that these are not unfamiliar feelings for any of us. How is this possible? How could we all be miserably failing at finding the things that our souls so desperately long for? What is the secret? I struggled with these questions for a very long time. It simply did not make sense. I began to wonder, if all of these desires were in me and everyone else I knew, why was it that nothing on this earth could fulfill them? We can all relate through these deep desires and agree that we want joy, satisfaction, purpose, and fulfillment, but none of us can find it. Then I heard this quote from C.S. Lewis that really forced me to consider these questions. If I find it myself, if I find in myself desires which nothing in this world can satisfy, the only logical explanation is that I was made for another world. It began to seem that I wasn't made for this world. This wasn't some idea that I made up, but this was something that my soul had been trying to tell me all along. And I saw this same struggle within other people. Suddenly I realized that this world wasn't enough, and it never would be, and this meant something. There had to be an explanation. These desires came from somewhere, and this world wasn't cutting it. Was it possible that these desires had been put within me? Had they been put within me in order to be fulfilled by a certain something or a certain person? We hunger and so there is food. We thirst and so there is water. We desire and so there must be fulfillment. Was it possible that these desires were meant to be filled by a divine creator who had put those desires there himself? Everything else had failed me and there was nowhere else to run, so I decided to explore this theory. I started seeking the God of the universe and my life changed. Everything started making sense. I suddenly saw why nothing else was working. My whole life I had been trying to find purpose and fulfillment in good grades and winning tennis matches and being cool, funny, and accepted and pleasing my parents and teachers. And I had it all wrong. Trying to fill myself with earthly things is like trying to make a car run on water. In order for a car to run, it has to be filled with gas. And in order for me to be fulfilled, I have to be filled with the source of all love and joy and goodness. And the only real source of this is knowing God. He created us. He knows what we need. We have a God-shaped hole inside of us. And when we try to fill it with anything other than God, it is quickly swallowed up and we are left empty again. I knew this emptiness as well as anyone. And then I let myself learn about the God of the universe. And I actually felt fulfilled. I actually felt loved. I actually felt worthy. I felt joy like I had never imagined. I felt joy like I had never imagined. I found out that I had a creator, a father that knew everything about me. He knew my soul inside and out. He knew it all, and somehow he loved me immeasurably. I learned that there is nothing I could do to make God love me more or make him love me less. I had never felt more free than when I found out I had someone who loved me absolutely unconditionally. This love rocked my world, shattered everything I had ever believed, and explained why nothing else ever worked. My life, my joy, my worth, and my purpose had been hidden in Christ the whole time, waiting to finally be discovered so that I could be set free and fulfilled once and for all. I'm telling you these things because I have suffered with you all. I have felt broken, lonely, and empty, and I know you guys have too. I want you guys to know that there's more than what this world offers. There's more than crushing expectations, more than money, more than being a slave to your career, more than straight A's, more than a boyfriend or girlfriend, more than laying in bed at night, questioning your existence and experiencing complete loneliness. Our whole lives we've been looking to the next thing, the next party, the next vacation, the next relationship, the next win, the next success. When we were in middle school, high school was that next thing. This graduation ceremony is one of those next things. And now our next thing is college, or the military, then a career, then a husband or wife, then kids, and then we watch our kids live out these next things. How many next things have to fail us before we see that they were never meant to fulfill us in the first place? In 12 hours, the graduation hype will have passed, and we will lay in bed tonight and again be alone with our thoughts and that feeling of what's next. And I want you to know that there doesn't have to be a next thing. We don't have to live a life full of next things followed by emptiness. We are faced with the sad truth that this world always leaves us unsatisfied. And whenever we feel this, I think we must consider the facts. We must ask ourselves, why is everything failing? Why do I feel so alone? Why can't I satisfy these desires? I think we are meant to live for more. We are meant to have something more. I can stand here before you, being the salutatorian of my class, with a full college scholarship, a loving family, incredible friends, and a state title, and tell you that none of these things come anywhere close to comparing to what it is like knowing the God of the universe and everything he has to offer. High school is over and you are left with a choice. You can do things the way you have always done them and put your hope into that next thing that has consistently failed you in the past, or you can try something new. You can venture into the unknown and experience what it is like to be fully known, fully accepted, and fully loved. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2015.
Thank you both, Roberto and Cassidy, for your powerful message. And now, our Hamilton High School Symphonic Band, under the direction of Mr. Paul Dixon.
As of the 1st of May, members of the Hamilton High School Class of 2015 have received over 300 scholarships and financial aid, totaling over $3.5 million. Because of the generosity of those people who contributed to University Alumni Foundations, our local Hamilton Community Foundation, Hamilton Service Clubs, professional organizations, and industrial firms, many of our seniors will be able to continue their education. The students who have received these awards have demonstrated excellence in the fields of academics, athletics, service to their school and to their community, or the discipline of fine arts. Many of these seniors have achieved in two or more of these areas. Our congratulations go out to you who have won these scholarships and awards, and to all of the parents and teachers who have been a part of them. Think of this recognition as not the end of an effort, but rather as one milestone on a long path, and know that you have made an excellent beginning. Now, will all of the recipients of an academic, college, or athletic scholarships or grants, awards of distinction, vocational and academic, or delayed entry in the armed service, please stand and be recognized. Thank you, you may be seated. Several years ago, the Hamilton High School staff established a scholarship to honor an outstanding graduating senior. Each year, through contributions from the staff, a $500 scholarship is given to a senior who displays not only a solid academic effort, but also very strong character. On behalf of the Hamilton High School faculty and staff, I am proud to announce the winner of this year's Hamilton High School Staff Scholarship. Alondra Solorzano Gomez, please stand and be recognized. And now our concert chorale, under the direction of Christina Fox, accompanied by our American Sign Language students, under the direction of Heather Hudak.
Like a ship blown from its glory by a wind of the like a seed dropped by a sky bird in a distant world. Who can say if I've been changed for the better?
Because I knew you,
I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blamed me for.
But then I guess we know there's blame to share,
and none of it seems to matter anymore.
Will the class of 2015 please rise? Mr. Krueger, it is an honor for me to present to you the 2015 Hamilton High School candidates for graduation.
Thank you, Mr. Wilhelm. On behalf of the school board, I want to first thank the parents, the family members, the friends of our graduating class. Your involvement through the years is directly related to our student success. And so I want to thank you all for being here today and continuing to support our students. To our staff and administration, your job is not easy, and it gets more difficult each and every year. But we thank you for your dedication to our students and our community at large. To our students, thank you for your years of hard work and dedication. I urge you to make each and every day an opportunity to learn something new. Please be willing to accept the new challenges that you will be faced, but also be confident that your education through the Hamilton City School District has prepared you to face those challenges and to overcome those obstacles. Congratulations. By the powers vested in me by the State of Ohio and the City of Hamilton, as President of the Hamilton Board of Education, I am happy to accept this group of students as eligible for graduation from Hamilton High School. At this time, I declare the class of 2015 of Hamilton High School graduated.
Please be seated. We will now present the class of 2015 with their diplomas. Please remember to hold all applause until all graduates are announced. Each graduate deserves to hear their name being called. Mr. Shermer, please begin.
We will begin commencement by recognizing our top 20 students in order of graduation. Roberto Alexander Castillo Gell. Cassidy Marie Hicks. Carrie Elizabeth Venefron. Alexander C. Sprague. Liberty Brooks Sands. Alexander Philip Shooter. Kaylin Lene Davish. Nathan Gregory Heimer. Allison Grove Chadwick. Abigail Grace Tompkins. Taylor Morgan Jones. Michael Adam Robbins. Martin Fritsch. Chelsea Nicole Rice. Sandra Guadalupe Oñate Munoz. Nicholas Anthony Brown. Riley Cole Engel. Brandon David Seiler. William Dempsey Holmes George. Jared Michael Morrison. As many of you know, our baseball team was originally scheduled to play in the baseball tournament today at 11 a.m. We had a bit of a conflict. So at this time, we are going to recognize our senior baseball players. They will receive their diplomas and then be dismissed from the commencement in order to make it to the game on time and bring home another victory. Jacob Daniel Baker. Matthew Christian Lee Ford. Brandon David Reif. Dallas Jonathan Wayne Robinson. Joseph Michael Gull. Samuel Henry Scott. Jacob Wilson Stewart. Terrence Brock Wilkie. Good luck and go Blue, Big Blue Baseball. We will now begin commencement of the rest of the student body.
Tyler Sean Allen Lakes. Jillian Jean Lancaster. Emily Marguerite Langhart. Chardonnay M. Laster. George L. Lawson III. Miranda LeBreton. Jennifer Alejandra Lechuga Pulido. Samantha Renee Lewis. Marissa D. Renee Lips. Daniel Anthony Little. Ronald Harley Little III. Kirsten Renee Lunsford. Diamond Alexis Maffitt. Paige M. Mahaney. Austin David Malone. Juana Natarnelli Mancibo Matos. Maria Guadalupe Mancera Rodriguez. Ashley Paige Markham. Jacob Knapp Mate. Courtney Renee Mathis.
Catherine Elizabeth Abney.
Scott Patrick McCarty.
Dakota Trelegs Adams.
Hope Barbara McLean.
Misty Nicole Adkins.
Connor Jacob McCracken.
Paige Whitley Allen.
Trevor A. McDaniel.
Marissa Corinne Amend.
Adam Michael McDuffie.
Billy Joe Bader II.
Abigail Jane McFall.
Cheyenne Gabrielle Bailey.
Ryan Scott McIntosh.
Barbara Suann K. Baker.
Alexia Danae McIntyre.
Deasia Christian Lee Banks.
Kristen Renee McKnight.
Alfredo Constantino Barajas Rojas.
Noel A. McNeil.
Carissa Lynn Barger.
Elizabeth Ray McNeil.
Christine Brianna Barnes.
Nicholas Ryan McQueen.
Charlie Ann Barrett.
Hunter Allen Meese.
Felicia Cheyenne Barrett.
Enrique Mercedes.
Avery L. Bartels.
Allison Haley Merrill.
Angelica Fabiola Batts Menju.
Tiffany Blake Miles.
Toriano Lawan Beeman Jr.
Destiny Ray Miller.
Brianna L. Benware.
Sabrina Victoria Miller.
Retevia J. Bisson.
Charles Kenneth Moore.
Michaela M. Black.
Elizabeth Renee Moore.
Tasherica Ion Black.
Jaymonique Sine Moore.
Alexis Brooke Blair.
Owen James Moore.
Destiny A.A. Blanton.
Ryan Matthew Moore.
Lainey Caitlin Blevins.
Paola Jeanette Morales Mahehi.
Jacob R. Boddicker.
Robert Chase Morgan.
Elizabeth Faith Bostick.
Hannah Marie Morris.
Natalie Paige Botner.
Veda Leanne Morrison.
Robert Edward Bunay.
Hannah Lillian Nicole Mueller.
Elizabeth Ray Bowman.
Stephanie Noel Lynn Mullins.
Ellie S. Boyd.
Tyler Chance Nath.
Raquan Boyd.
Zachary David Nash.
Megan Jordan Boyer.
Alexander Jackson Newsom.
Mark Boyle.
T-
Tyler Michael Niehoff.
Jasmine M. Bradbury.
Sarah Catherine Knorr.
Leanne Jeanette Brewer D'Angelo.
Annalise Barbara Noonan.
Coney Wayne Brockman.
Cooper Nathaniel Osborne.
Davion Raquel Brown.
Caitlin Michelle Overby.
Sierra Mariah Broyles.
Tiana Lynn Marie Owens.
Jessica Paige Bruns. Victoria Ann Marie Buell.
Dallinger Leon Pace Jr.
Brian Lai Bowie.
Sylvia Juana Rosa Palma.
Jordan T. Bowie.
Trey Thomas Parr.
Andrew James Bunn.
Alexis Desiriah Parson.
Caleb Christopher Lee Burke.
David Scott Patrick.
Devante Dominic Burrell.
Brandon Michael Pendergrass.
Kristen Rosemary Burtis.
Kaylee Brian Penley.
Elizabeth Dawn Burton.
Ivante Ramona Perez.
Shelby Lynn Bushnell.
Melodis Perez Cano.
Andrea Lynn Bussell.
Grant Anthony Perkins.
Zachary Edward Butler.
Jason Andrew Pettit.
Kaylin Dawn Buttery.
Caitlin Nicole Pettit.
Brittany Danielle Bird.
Mark William Philhauer.
Taylor Danielle Camden.
Cassandra Rayanne Phillips.
James Alexander Cannon.
Kayla Lynn Phillips.
Daniel A. Carnegie.
Arian Nairay Platt.
Kaylin Rochelle Daisy Carwell.
Ariel Simone Parada.
Paul William Carlisle.
Courtney Jordan Powell.
Ashley Nicole Carroll.
Robert Alexander Powell.
Lindsay Caitlin Carter.
Courtney Blake Price.
Olivia M. Castillo.
Gunner Lee Price.
Megan Marie Caudill.
Jacob Chandler Price.
Cynthia Rochelle Serna Smith.
Alicia Monique Pride.
Carlos Omar Severa Jacinto.
Lashana E. Pride.
Walker D. Cheney.
Logan J. Privet.
Carly K. Charles.
Cody Jacob Prophet.
Robert Blair Church.
Rachel Emily Queen.
Taylor T. Claire.
Dylan Adam Prophet.
Andrew James Clark.
Heidi Penelope Ramirez.
Mackenzie Faye Clark.
Alondra Isabel Ramirez Mendez.
Jose A. Claros.
Julieta Susana Ramos Garcia.
Keith W. Cobb.
Caitlin Darlene Randall.
Jared A. Cochran.
Keith W. Randolph, Jr.
Nadej Damian Collier.
Lucia May Razzo.
Alexis Brooke Calhoun.
Dalton L. Reams.
Delissa S.M. Colvin.
Lydia Atanasia Ricalde.
Colin Scott Combs.
Jordan Clark Reed.
Marilee Shega Combs.
Brianna Dominique Richardson.
Kylie Madison Coomer.
Thomas Eugene Rink III.
David Aaron Coons.
Christian Francisco Javier Roa Ramirez.
Trad Anthony James Cooper.
Jaylee Shelby Simone Roark.
Matthew Corder.
Tyler Douglas Roark.
Brianna Joe Cockcamp.
Taylor Danielle Robbins.
Cassandra Renee Cox.
Broderick Malik Jones Roberts.
Adam Robert Crouch.
Corey A. Rodriguez.
Kaylin Dawn Croucher.
Brianna Marie Rodriguez Yanez.
Corinne Elizabeth Crum.
Jamie Ryan Rogers Jr.
Angelica C. Cup.
Alexander Allen Rose.
Janae Denise Curtis.
Dylan L. Rose.
Jameel Raquan Daniels.
Mason James Rule.
John Miles Davidson.
Brennan A. Rush.
Justin D. Dawson.
Hannah Marie Rush.
Sebastian Jeremy Dawson.
Zachary Tyler Sampson.
Alejandro I. Diaba Villa.
Lake James Sams.
Samuel De Jesus Garcia.
Caleb Sandlin.
Tyler Donovan DeBoer.
Zachary Tyler Santos.
Dalton R. Detheridge.
Austin Edward Sapp.
Summer Marie Day.
Catherine Ann Sarber.
Jared Dalton Dolemeyer.
Skylar Wayne Sawyers.
Janaea Monique Douglas.
Michaela Sky Scalf.
Jennifer Lynn Dooley.
Megan Lynn Scalf.
Eric Tremont Duncan.
Trinity Marie Schaefer.
Kaylee Lynn Eaton.
Ryan Andrew Cedar.
Nicole Ann Elam.
Cassandra K. Sharp.
Lafayette Devante Elkins.
Alexander A. Sherlock.
Ronald D. Eubanks.
Jeffrey Isaiah Short.
Maria Lynn Falcone.
Abigail M. Schumard.
Haley E. Faulkner.
Vanya Agricia Seguenza.
Manuel Alexander Felice Mija.
Timothy Michael Simmons.
Justin M. Fields.
Zachary Taylor Simpson.
Tristan D. Fields.
Lorenzo Deshaun Singletary Holmes.
Marlene Figueroa.
Sydney Taylor Singleton.
Mateo Elijah Christopher Flores.
Taylor Lee Skinner.
Caitlin Elizabeth Foyster.
Tristan Spencer Sloan.
Rachel Louise Forsyth.
Kenneth J. Smiley II.
Lanisha Deshaun Alice Franklin.
Brooke Nicole Smith.
Haley Nicole Frazier.
Connor James.